Okay, there we go. Is it incorrectly there? Hello, everyone. Welcome to Wallace and Gromit and Project Zoo, one of the few video games starring Wallace and Gromit. If I can just get my water bottle open, that'd be great. Thank you. Now, I looked up some reviews while I was getting set up. This game isn't known for being very good. But do I have a save file in slot 3? How old is that save file? Hey, Simkey. Hey, Belle. So Zeno is out of commission tonight. He got back from surgery very late. And he is currently just sitting on the couch. So, Simkey will be a temp mod for tonight. Hopefully Zeno will be feeling better by the next time I stream. He's doing fine. It's kind of hard for him to talk right now, and, you know, since it was surgery on his nose, it's not really easy for him to eat and drink right now, but he's doing fine. Alright, so how do I... Alright. This save file is from when I was a kid. This came out in 2003, so who knows how old this is. It's kind of... Where is that? Let's see here. Oh! There we go. Actual widescreen. That's cool. Oh, that looks so much better. Oh, there we go. Extras. So I know there aren't many people in chat at the moment, but which of you have watched Wallace and Gromit? Because I grew up watching them.
Anything planned for today, Gromit? Oh, is it his birthday already? Oh, champion! That means a trip to the zoo. Did you remember to get him a little something or other? Oh, my word, yes, Archie'll love that. Much fresher than tinned. Just the thing for a growing polar bear. He's lucky to have us as sponsors. Clear these things away, lad, and we'll deliver it in person.
Yeah, we had the VHS tape of the three shorts. I think it was a box set. Then we got them on DVD and later Blu-ray.
I'm going to speak to the authorities about this.
Along with the fourth matter of loaf and death and Chris the Rare Rabbit.
Could you give me the telephone number for West Wallaby Zoo, please? The zoo's gone ex-directory? This is most irregular.
So for those who are unfamiliar with the shorts,
I say,
that penguin... is Feathers McGraw, the villain of The Wrong Trousers.
What is it, lad? Heavens above, Gromit, it's Archie. And he's sending us a message by airmail. Let me see that. Blinkin' Nora, Gromit. And there's more and all. SOS Archie, the little lad's in trouble. Feathers McGraw. But he's supposed to be doing porridge in the penguin house. There's something pretty fishy going on here, lad, and it's not just Archie's birthday present. Oh, yes. This should get us inside the zoo, all right. Remember what they say, lad? The penguin is mightier than the sword.
Hmm? Oof, that frame rate. Oh my god, it's a Trojan penguin.
Easy over the cobbles, lad. No one has spilled me cocoa.
Of course he's got the armchair in there. D-Day battle plan? This is Feathers McGraw, so that's actually a little harder than it sounds, because he's pretty devious.
Action stations, Gromit. Our plan seems to have worked. The penguin has landed. We're inside the zoo, all right, but I can't see any animals. Oh, and now I can't see anything. You haven't got another 10p, have you, lad? And when we do get outside, lad, no barking at the big cats. Silence will be our secret weapon. Oh, give me a shove, Gromit. Me tank top's caught on the latch. Release that bear cub at once, Feathers McGraw, or I'll set me dog on you. Oi! Come back here, you! Come back at once! Oh, unhitch me, lad!
So I need to point out something about who developed this game.
To the jungle house, lad! And don't spare the horses!
Spare the horses? This game was developed by Frontier Developments. Depending on whether you grew up playing PC games, that name may sound familiar to you. Because they were the creators of Zoo Tycoon, Roller Coaster Tycoon, Elite Dangerous, Planet Coaster, Planet Zoo, Thrillville, and Jurassic World Evolution.
Better collect them. Never know when they'll come in handy. I spy trouble ahead. Why are they all working so hard? And look at that young man.
Oh, it was defeated a moment ago.
Stuck it in a cage. Who'd be so cruel and heartless? Feathers McGraw. And he's using his control thingamy to send the whatchamacallit over the ujamaflip. We're not standing for this. His parents can't rescue him, but by heck, we will.
Wait, did it just fix itself?
Have a nose around for some more nuts, lad. I may be able to recycle this into something more useful.
Is Black Borders on stream? There are on my monitor, too, so I think that's just permanently stuck with us. Yeah, that looks correct. It's just got the black borders.
Number two flathead, I think.
Ah, it's for cutscenes.
Shabby build, this. Hey, look out behind. Nearly got me there.
Yeah, do you guys think you can deal with it? Because I'd have to get a little creative to get rid of the black borders.
Look at that action, Gromit. May I present the telescopic banana gun?
You're gonna die.
Scarper.
Press the B button.
So, anyways.
Fire your weapon.
So.
This way then, Gromit.
If you had never played this game before, it's a Ratchet and Clank clone. Oh. It's a Ratchet and Clank clone. With the catch being that I have to keep an eye on Wallace. Monty's Monkey Hunt. I can just save whenever. That's good. I'm a clone? Well, I think I'm a clone now. Yeah, that was the wrong option. Okay.
Press the Y button to activate an information point. Tap the X button to put away or get out your current weapon.
Okay, I can't change the camera controls, which is irritating. I'm going to move the camera up by moving the... I'm going to move the camera down by moving the stick up. I am now going to move the stick down. I am now going to move the stick left. I am now going to move the stick right. Up and down, and right and left are inverted, and there are no settings for it. Yeah, apparently one of this game's biggest criticisms was the camera controls.
Ammunition for your weapons can be got from vending machines.
I got a coin. What'd it do? My controller upside down. I'm not doing that.
Varying your speed may help you to cross narrow platforms.
Fuck it, I'm just gonna run. I shoot it again. Nope.
Two ticks and I'll be there. Take that out.
Also, that is actually Peter Salas as Wallace. Peter Salas is no longer with us, but you know, it is nice to hear his voice again. Y'all don't understand. I loved Wallace and Gromit when I was a kid.
Use the control stick to make Gromit swim.
I am, like, genuinely surprised I didn't wear out the damn VHS tape how many times I watched it. I like how Gromit dog paddles, which I guess makes sense because he's a dog. So, I do own another Wallace and Gromit game that I've been meaning to play for a very long time, and I will try to get running on my Steam Deck to stream at some point. I feel a yawn coming. There it is. And that would be Wallace and Gromit, Wallace and Gromit's Grand Adventures, which was a Telltale game.
Wallace can fix many devices using nuts and bolts.
Like Banjo-Kazooie? Is Banjo-Kazooie in this game? Hey, it's fixed. Now what?
Any ideas, old chum?
Wallace can fix many devices.
Well, it's fixed. I guess that's good. Alright. Hello. Oh, I don't like this. There's the peaches again. Birds being bird, I suppose. Will we hear a bandit is the question. Wow, a coin! Yay. Wallace, did you fix the damn machine yet? I don't know what's setting the bird off. Maybe he hears the birds in the game. Alright, so I'm assuming that's my health. I don't know what that is. It looks like the fucking Lumbus bread from Lord of the Rings. I will say, from the reviews I looked up, this game isn't supposed to be all that great. I don't care. Yeah, the birds in the game, you know. Well, the funny thing is, in some games, when you hear a bird, it's actually a sun conure. Like Peaches. Oh, I actually had a Y button on there. I guess. Yeah. Peaches sure wants it to be known that he's conscious. Is there something back there? There it is. That hurt me. Yep. Is that the dog sound effect from Earthworm Jim? Alright, so not a whole lot happening at the moment. Yeah, that bird sound that just played, that is a sun conure, or at least a conure.
Use the control stick. Climb up and down ladders.
And do I get the gun? I have a gun. I have a banana gun. See? Don't know why I didn't have it selected there, but okay.
Press the A button, hold the B button, and use the control stick to climb up and down ropes.
Oh, give me the coin.
Boxes and other objects can be smashed using the B button.
Like how British everything is. So why do only some of these get animations? Yeah, Gromit's got a gun. But see, it's okay. Because it's a banana gun. Ring, 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 ring. Banana gun. Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding. Banana gun. It grows in bunches. In fact, my lunch is, I don't know the rest. I do know later on there's a porridge gun. I did get that far!
Swim and push into an edge to make Gromit climb out of the water.
Thank you. Very helpful. Is there a coconut gun? There easily could be a coconut gun. I wouldn't put it past them. Unless Nintendo's got a monopoly on that. Which they easily could. Considering they, you know, pioneered the concept of flinging coconuts at people at a terminal velocity. Probably, I swear to God, if you... Okay. Okay, there's an auto-targeting system.
Gromit can jump further if running before jumping.
Why did he pronounce it like that? Gromit can jump further if he tries running before jumping. What was with that? Well, that could have been bad. Auto aim, more like auto lame. Oh, we're good. Oh, those are crackers. Oh, because cheese and crackers. That's right. That's Wallace's favorite snack. Crackers, Gromit. We've forgotten the crackers. The stream is just going to be me quoting Wallace and Gromit randomly for 3 hours.
Some objects can be moved if you push them.
Hey, did my health go down? It's in my health. Alright, I guess you just have infinite lives. Well, that's good.
Ow! Stop it!
To open cages, go up to the cage and press the Y button.
Nice going, Gromit.
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure he's still paying attention. You never know, Wallace.
Right you are, then.
Give.
This is the right way, eh? Huh? Yes?
Listen, my only way of interacting with something is to attack it. That's just what I'm going to do. A wrench.
Some devices need tools before Wallace can fix them. Hold the R button and press the A button.
Oh, that'll do nicely.
Doesn't even use the wrench. That's the next area. I don't want to go just that. I can't hold more than 50. Oh my god, I can dodge roll. Oh, Oh, Christ, it's a bonus level. Hey, this game has bonus levels. That was the bonus level. Yeah, they went all out for Wallace and Gromit platformer, I guess. Like I said, this game isn't supposed to be particularly good. Okay, well, I didn't realize I was... What have I gotten myself into? What is this soundtrack? Alright, I'm noticing a trend here. Press jump to jump. Wasn't there a game that literally says that and doesn't tell you what the button is? Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon. Yeah, doesn't Ubisoft have... Oh, I got him. Alright, so jumping is a little delayed here. Doesn't Ubisoft have a trend of really weird control schemes in their games, especially on PC? Horse tutorial that the main character bitches about while they still make you do it. Yeah, that sounds about right. Because I know Xeno tried to play the Assassin's Creed game on PC. I don't know which one. I think it was 2. And he stopped playing it. Because he loaded the game, tried to figure out how to play, and it said press the leg button to move. Played AC, but Far Cry tends to have either standard or close to standard controls. Actually, it did try. Oh, okay. Yeah, I've played. Why was there a loading? Okay. Oh, wonderful. I have played Assassin's Creed 3 and 4 on Wii U, but not for very long. And that is all the Assassin's Creed I will ever play. Really, guys? Let me guess. Yep. That's what I thought. This is a low-budget 3D platformer, so... So, this is more of a question for Simkey than Bal, since I know Bal doesn't really play platformers. But what is worse for you? A bad platformer or a boring platformer? Well, Bal, you don't play platformers. There's no point in really having you answer the question. I know Simkey does, though. Honestly, I would actually rather have a... Yeah, a boring platformer is definitely worse than a bad platformer, because at least with a bad platformer, you have something you can make fun of as long as it's not too frustrating. And usually bad platformers have a lot of weird shit going for them, which makes them, funnily enough, not boring. A boring platformer, on the other hand, is just wasted potential. Also, I did not see Bell's other message. You're probably not playing a Ubisoft game ever again. That's fair. If I am playing a Ubisoft game again, it's going to be a game I bought used. And I mean like an old game, like Prince of Persia, or Beyond Good and Evil, and that kind of stuff. Thankfully, I already own most of the Ubisoft games that I wanted, so I don't have to buy anymore. There's just 2 old Rayman games I want to get. and a couple of the original Prince of Persia games. Like SNES Genesis Prince of Persia. Alright, so the correct option was to not try to jump off of it, because it just carries my momentum. I'm gonna keep trying, I'm getting this damn coin. Also, Bell, I do agree with you that it can be applied to almost any genre. Yeah, I will say, Bell, you do have a very specific interest in shooters, and I know that's... Yeah, I'm not, like, trying to make fun of you for it or anything, it's just... You know what you like. And that's fine. And I actually kind of forgot that Ghost Recon, or Tom Clancy's games in general... Was it his games? His name was on them. But the Tom Clancy games in general do fall under that. Personally, I've never been a fan of military games, even before I was, like, politically aware. They just never really interested me. Why not? It's just... You do play a lot that fall under that. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm not, like, trying to call you out or anything. It's just... God damn it. I mean, I play a lot of roguelikes, I play a lot of cartoony games. I mean, I play a lot of different kinds of games, but there's definitely trends you can see that I like. Hey, Necro, I haven't seen you in a while. Alright, I have been on this bonus level for the past 10 minutes. I'm gonna try a couple more times, and I'm probably just gonna exit, if I can exit. You believe in me? Oh, let's see how long that lasts. Also, Necro, it's funny you bring that up. Because, the day I learned what Scromiting was an illustration of Scromiting by having Gromit Scromiting. I have owned this since I was a kid, and I never finished it. I think the game isn't as good as I remember, because I remember it being halfway decent. Did I just... I held the button for too long. Also, God, I missed Blockbuster. You're afraid to know what scrumming is? It's when you scream and vomit at the same time. Progress! Oh, you guys would hit. Give me a couple more flats. I don't know why there's another platform right there.
Gromit!
Hey, Wallace.
Gromit!
To be honest, I kind of feel like my interest in the modern military shooters came from seeing previews and reviews of COD 4 back in the day and not having a system to be able to properly run it until much later. About a few PS2 era pre-COD 4 shooters like Black and Delta Force. Yeah. Yeah, that's fair. I mean, I'm very picky about my shooters because I grew up playing Doom, Quake, and Unreal Tournament, so... If a first-person shooter doesn't play like any of those games, it's very hard for me to enjoy it, which is why I don't like Halo all that much.
Up you go, lad. Show us your monkey impression.
Monkey! Monkey. You showed me, monkey. can. Why am I getting nuts out of the pottery? A lot of messages.
Go and have a root around for some more tools, would you, lad?
If I don't want to shoot the birds. I take offense to this. Plenty of games when you were a kid you thought were good but aren't. Yeah, that's just kind of what happens. That's the natural part of growing up. Enjoy military shooters, although it's been a while since we had a good one. Got into Halo because my brother had an EGM magazine covering Halo 3 with a sick illustration of an elite on the cover. EGM. That was the magazine that had Sean Baby's Rest of the Crap on it, right? Like at the end of the magazine, every issue. Yeah, I was subscribed to that at one point. I actually was subscribed to it, close to when it ended. Like, about a year or two, and then when it ended for a little bit, in order to fill out their remaining orders, they, sent everyone copies of Maxim. Which pissed off a lot of parents, because the, people didn't quite realize that a lot of minors were subscribed to the magazine. What happened to all my bananas? I can't believe they made me come all the way down here just to do that. Brother had his subscription from 2003 to 2008. I think my subscription was 2007? Sometime?
Top notch, Gromit.
What a bold drill. Bastard! I do have jump options here. Yawn again.
Many objects can be shot. You need the banana gun.
I'll have to see if I can get Soldier of Fortune working on something. Is it available on Steam? Is it available anywhere? I think it's on GOG. I can see what I can get working with that. GOG is a little harder to get working on Linux than Steam. Oh my god, that's the actual box of crackers from the show. I just noticed. Stop deselecting my goddamn banana gun. Have it on GOG. Okay. If someone could look up if it's actually allowed to be streamed on Twitch, I would assume yes. But I just want to be safe. There are not many games on Twitch that are banned from streaming because of violence. There's a couple console versions that are decent. I didn't know there were console versions. Because I had heard of the game before. It's legal? Okay. I gotta stand on the plate. Okay.
We'll find a use for this and no mistake.
Oh, why did I get super fast all of a sudden? This is some fairly basic platform in here. That's another one of the complaints that this game got, is that the platforming just isn't very good. It's very basic. Wait, how come that didn't kill me, but the one in the other game area did? Okay. Alright, so we get to go all the way back up. Oh, do I need to bring Wallace up here with me? Hang on a sec here.
Where are you, lad? Gromit? It's a bit further than I thought. Nearly there, lad. Gromit? More use here, I think, lad.
Alright, how do I get the baby elephant down? Where's the hint system? Let's get the baby over the spikes. Soldier of Fortune 1 is sick. Yeah, I remember you talking about that during the Splatoon stream. Why does it have a loading screen by any pause? Boy, that monkey's got range. Okay, so the camera controls randomly speed up. Just saying. I forgot the Y button can interact with stuff. Look at Orc doing.
Whoa!
The PS2 version has broken graphics. How is that even possible? They added grain and desaturated everything. Okay. A coin! Drawbridge. There's probably something I can shoot, isn't there? Let me do it for you. I can do it for you. Anything over here I can interact with. Can't pull that down. Get so many faster than that. I don't understand what it wants me to do. I understand what it wants me to do. Like a Wallace escort mission. It basically is. Wallace may have been an inventor, but Gromit was really the one pulling all the weight. purpose did that serve? Ah, forget it. Who needs it? Not me. I've got bigger fish to fry. Fish to fry? I haven't had a fried fish in a while. Hello. I like how they just drop. This game is a Wallace escort mission. Its gameplay is kind of a riff on Ratchet and Clank. Actually, when did Ratchet and Clank come out? Was it before 2003? I've played all the PS2 Ratchet and Clank, so the first one definitely feels like a 2003 era game.
Be there in a jiffy.
2002? Yeah, this game came out in 2003. I'm good.
Carry on, lad. I'm right behind you. Honest.
Sorry, what? Hidden Temple of Montezuma. Now, I can't think of the name Montezuma without thinking of the phrase Montezuma's Revenge. Montezuma's Revenge is what happens when you drink water in Mexico without being used to the water there. I guess I'm just not gonna get any of those bolts. Fuck you guys then. I'm gonna tear in a moment. Fucking freeze like that, game. Jesus Christ. Crackers! God, I'm suddenly craving crackers. Honestly, though, like, cheese and crackers is actually really good. So this is the correct way to go, so I'm gonna backtrack real quick and see what else I can find. Yeah, if you haven't actually had cheese and crackers before...
Top notch, Gromit.
It's actually a really good snack. Stop! Mm-hmm. 3D Wallace isn't real, he can't hurt you. Well, Wallace was always 3D, technically, because it was stop motion. But yeah, there is something uniquely terrifying about Wallace's 3D model in this. Gromit looks fine. Wallace just looks off because of the fucking shading. I would very much like... I'm gonna save. So I would very much like the game to stop doing that. If you haven't had cheese and crackers before, I don't think you exist. Well, I'll be honest. I had cheese and crackers as a kid because of Wallace and Gromit. Though, if you want a little extra on your cheese and crackers, this is going to sound weird, put pickle slices on it. It's actually really good. When I was still a brony, there was a webcomic called The Horsewife. which was about a guy who had married a pony. It was a wholesome comic. Kind of weird looking back on it, though. And one of the suggestions in the... or one of the snacks that the horse wife in the comic liked was cheese and crackers with pickles. It sounded kind of weird, but I wanted to try it, and I did, and it's actually really good. So, yeah. I understand I'm outing myself a little bit, but I have not been part of the brony fandom in several years. I, left it, when I noticed that the brony fandom has an unusually high level of Nazis in it. And I'm just gonna leave it at that. Is it centaur wife or horse wife? It's an actual horse wife. She was an actual pony. The comic was called... it was a Tumblr blog, technically, but it was called The Horse Wife. I see how this is gonna be. This is really just a black room. I like how Gromit's model is actually pretty expressive. And then there's Wallace. Oh, dude. Yeah, there's something just off about him. He looks like something someone you'd see in the back rooms. May just be the game's lighting system. Yeah, like, it's so weird, because Gromit is so expressive and animated, and then Wallace is just standing there. Menacingly. I never noticed this before. He just looks wrong. To be fair, this is Frontier Developments. And while they make good games, this was the era when they were making a lot of weird stuff. Because they made a game called A Dog's Life, where you play as a dog. Not a talking dog. You play as an actual dog. And you, sniff things to find stuff. Oh, I thought that was just going to crush me. That would have been really bad if that would have just crushed me. Yeah, I only know about A Dog's Life because Snuffy, another VTuber, had streamed it a while ago. And I'd never heard of it before. Oh, so that's why he was just standing there. Oh. Because Snuffy had apparently played A Dog's Life when she was a kid. That was a weird-ass fucking game. Yeah, Frontier made that. Frontier made a lot of stuff in this era. They're known for Zoo Tycoon, Roller Coaster Tycoon, Thrillville, Planet Coaster, Planet Zoo, the Jurassic World Evolution games, and Elite Dangerous. That's what they're known for. And they did actually make some of the other Elite games. But they also had a lot of weird games like this that were just low-budget licensed games, probably to make back what they weren't getting on their other games, because that was actually a common thing at the time. Bethesda actually made a bunch of licensed games.
Objects can be used to see in dark places. They can also be used to set fire to things.
To set fire to things. This is so British. Well, I mean, I guess I'm not answering that.
Torches can be used to see in dark places. They can also be used to set fire to things.
So, I think I've just discovered something. Give me a sec here. Yeah, Gromit can't grab ledges when he's holding the torch. Yeah, like, now that you've mentioned it, this is actually oddly weird, but we have a bit of a bigger problem. You see these ledges? I can't grab them while I have the torch. So I need to do this. Now, you're probably thinking to yourself, I bet Spike can't see the ledge. And you're right. Well, I can see it from this angle. Guys, I think I made an error pick in this game. I am going to stick through it. I don't care if it's bad, because I've been wanting to finish this since I was a kid. I know it's not very good. But does everything need to be good? Does everything need to be a masterpiece? Do I really need to only ever play good games? The answer is yes, but I'm going to fail that anyways. Oh boy, my favorite part of Ratchet & Clank, melee attacks. Also, what is with this music? Guys, are we in the back rooms? Does this enter the back rooms featuring Wallace and Gromit? See, at least this is going to be entertaining, but the thing is, it's going to be entertaining for the wrong reasons. Sounds like the spirit realm and tackle. Wait, do you mean tackling the power of Juju? Oh my god, that just unlocked some memories. I never owned that game. I don't own it now. But I remember playing it at a McDonald's. You guys remember when McDonald's would have the little Gamecube stations or the N64 stations? One of the McDonald's that I went to often had a Gamecube set up with Sonic Heroes, Super Monkey Ball 2, and Tackling the Power of Juju. This game almost feels fake. I really wonder if they were trying to make a different game and then just slapped a Wallace and Gromit license at the last second.
Hold the X button and use the control stick to change weapons.
Is that a fucking Soviet propaganda poster from Feathers McGraw? Not Soviet. Actually, yeah, no, this could be some kind of propaganda poster. Also, when did he have the time to set that up? More crackers.
Here.
Not trying to get your attention, Wallace. We'll come when you're called. Oh, by the way. So, can you tell at a glance which gear items have something in them? I can tell you which ones, it's left in the bottom. But they're not lit up to signify that there's something selectable there. They have a different icon, which, at a glance, might just look like the regular icon. Wallace and Gromit debuted 2 years before the fall of the Soviet Union, so it's aesthetically accurate. Wait, when did the Soviet Union fall? That was the 90s, wasn't it? God, I keep forgetting that was the 90s. 91. Oh god, why is it smooth aiming? Oh my god. Why does the rope have collision? Why is my reticle still visible? I didn't want to look.
Isn't that? Oh, the poor little mite. Leave this one to me, Gromit. Geronimo!
People are going up and down these stairs. And there's the bird again. Peaches, it is 8:17. I'm gonna save real quick. Download Soldier of Fortune on your Steam Deck and it works. How did you download it? And how did you get it working? Did it just work automatically? Did you download it through GOG Galaxy? Ow. Ow. Again. I saw this thing called Heroic, logged in with my GOG account, and... Okay, that's what Heroic Launcher is. God, what is with that loading screen? Why is there a loading screen right on pause? Yeah, Heroic is something that I was looking at. I've been checking all my games on ProtonDB, and I remember seeing Heroic there. So now I know what that is. There is an app that I got for Pop OS, which is my laptop's operating system at one point, called Game Hub, which lets you do the same thing. You can download stuff from itch.io and GOG and run them through Proton. You can also download stuff through Steam, but you probably already had Steam installed, so it was kind of pointless for that, at least. So I'll make sure to download Heroic.
Oh, that penguin hadn't reckoned on us when he lo- Ah! It's a booby trap! Something, Gromit!
Heroic seems to be specifically for GOG and EGS.
Mind you, every cloud has a pot of gold with a silver lining. It smashed a way out for us. Come on, Gromit!
That's another yawn. Yeah, I don't really use my itch.io account. I made one just to have it, but I never really used it.
Just coming, Gromit. Not what I'd expected.
Did he just take a shit? Wait. Did you guys hear shitting noises? Oh yeah, Wallace is just stimming.
Okay, be there in no time at all.
I can't do it again. Hey, if you guys don't know what stimming is, it's just something that people who have attention deficit or attention disorders do. It's literally what Wallace is doing now, just different motions, especially stuff with his hands. I do it a lot because I'm autistic and I have ADHD. That's literally what he's doing. Why is he doing that? Wow, his idle animations play out so fucking fast. Wallace does it because it's a video game NPC. Wow, that is some tight collection, collectible bullshit I need. And I actually missed the tool.
Whatever could this be? What the heck? You don't see that every day.
This game's lighting is uncanny. Oh, excuse me. I just had some leftover bourbon chicken and rice earlier. So I'm burping a bit. Gaming in the bush years. Yeah, I'm actually glad I'm streaming this because this is,
Feather's been busy. This wasn't here last time we...
This is entertaining for all the wrong reasons.
Under West Wallaby Zoo. Most irregular.
What
on earth has Feathers been up to? He's a penguin, not a minor bird. Whatever it is, he doesn't want us to see. That lock's been pickled. If I could find a way to give you a leg up, you could shimmy through that vent and open up from the other side. You need something to put a spring in your step. Oh yes, they're just the ticket. A tad heavier than plimsolls, but they'll pack a real punch. Ready to test drive my go-higher springy boots, eh? patent pending. Careful with that cast. Well, they
the boots made a piano wire? What's with that noise? Is this the boss fight?
Can you see anything, Gromit? Let me in when you found the latch. That Feathers is in for a surprise, all right. We'll catch him unawares.
That didn't look like a button. That looks like a button. A lot of people are going into the basement. Oh my god! Get some health, please. It didn't look like his health meter was going down. Is that Elon Musk's self-driving boring machine? No, if it was self-driving, it would have been aiming at children, not a dog.
Number three. Never leave home without one. By heck, look at the spikes on that. Could do somebody a mischief if it weren't broken.
This is the cop version.
Feathers McGraw! Come here, you! After him, Gromit! Count down to
D. It would also explode on its own.
D-Day was donkey's years ago. This way, if Feathers is down here, then...
So, do you guys notice the, flags, right? The suspicious red-colored flags with a symbol in the top in the center. for this is going to relive World War II. Yeah, I need to stress this game is aimed at children. E for everyone. Mild cartoon violence. Whoops. Oh, that could have hit the reset button. That would have been bad.
I mean, there's no coal mine.
God, I remember this level. This level's a nightmare.
Careful, man. The trunk's out. And I think I can see the problem. The control panel's been knobbled.
Been knobbled?
One fretty knob. We'll soon turn the turntables on the fancy wind. Oh, another blinking cliche. But at least I
coal mine is where you got stuck. I think I got past the coal mine because I had a save file still active that was in the area after this.
Ahoy there, Pooch.
Danger. Fast moving carts. Do not walk on the track.
I'm gonna walk on the track and you can't stop me. The beavers. Find a way through to the station. Okay. So, why... Okay, A. No. I go up. A, yes. B. No. What is the... If B can be no, what is the point of making me go up? Wait a second. I only just noticed. If B can... This game is gonna be the death of me. Also, these aren't hints. This is my objective. Why is that a hint? It's not a hint. It's telling me what I'm supposed to do. That's not a hint. A hint is supposed to give me guidance. There's some strong vibrations coming from this damn controller.
I'm sure we can recycle this.
Yeah, we're gonna get some coal. What did I... The Donkey Kong Country soundtrack. Stop freezing. I guess I just can't hurt those guys. So you know judo well, is that it? It's not an Austin Powers reference, is it? Like clean burning ecologically friendly coal. Oh, the succulent Chinese meal guy. We were talking about that in the Splatoon stream. Sorry, delays likely this way out. Oh my god! just enough time.
Torches can be used to see in dark places. They can also be used to set fire to things.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that would have killed me from where I'm standing. Can I please get some crackers? Wait, your nut count? Nut count. Your nut count is separate between areas, by the way.
Hey, I can't see you.
Can you just interact with the other thing, please? Yeah, I mean, like, with that much dynamite, that would have taken out this entire cliff face. You kidding? I'm not good with explosions, but oh, Christ. Even I know that.
I'm staying here, Gromit.
Oh, and you want me to light that? Yeah, I'm sure I can survive this. Oh, I see what the game wants. There's like literally nothing here. Gromit, get out. Also, if that was real, that would have taken out... This entire thing would have collapsed. Yeah, all it broke was the crates. That is not how dynamite works. It actually ended up killing the enemy for me. Really?
Playing with the signals can cause accidents.
Yeah, I mean, like, that should be an entrance to a bonus level, honestly, and it's not. Oh god, the fucking smooth aiming again. Oh! Oh, what the fuck. Isn't there a character named Max Headroom? Wait, isn't that the guy that, Yeah, wasn't there a weird thing that happened where a dude was wearing a Max Headroom mask and just hijacked a broadcast? Or something? Because I think that's what Eminem is referencing in his Rap God music video in the intro. Something like that. And from what I remember, it's one of the weirdest things to happen in the U.S. No one knows, I still remember, no one knows who he was, no one knows how he got a hold of the broadcast. Or how he did it. He just did it. Platformers really know how to tempt people with greed. What am I targeting?
Gromit! Where are you, lad?
You're looking right at me, buddy. For the nut, doll.
Come over here.
There's a dog looking for his nut. I don't know why I did that. Never found out how Max Headroom, or the Max Headroom guy, did it. They used a stronger signal than the TV station. Okay, that's. What is with this opera music? Why is there an opera singer in my song about a coal mine? Oh, hi. I'll be honest, the music actually isn't all that bad. By the way, every time you die, you lose all your extra, ammo, that's the word. Too expensive. I think he was part of Microsoft at the time because of Rare. grabbed by the ghoulies. I thought that... Isn't that a game supposed to be, like, painfully average? It's with this aiming. Everything about this game is just wrong. We have Grant Kirkhope at home. The Grant Kirkhope at home.
Do not, under any circumstances, try to escape by riding a minecart.
Does it look like I care about your rules?
Feathers has captured another little one. Quick, Gromit, grab that rope. And hang on tight. Which is that you, Lan?
What is even the point of the button?
I'll just wait here. Beaver will be happy. I'm trapped, lad. You'll have to get me out. But try not to blow us all off.
The workers won't oppress themselves.
Lost that fuse, Gromit.
Ah, I see.
Atta boy, Gromit.
Forage gun that I don't have yet. I'll get in soon.
Hard hats to be worn at all times.
Better find some more tools for this job, Gromit.
So weird. Okay, I'm good. Why would you do that, Gromit? What is that mechanic? Gromit, you better do all the work, lad. Stern talking to after this. Why is there a fucking sweet spot? What have I gotten myself into, guys? Hopefully Wednesday's game is going to be a little better. It's Castlevania Legacy of Darkness, which isn't one of the best Castlevanias, but it's a lot better than its predecessor. Because it is a reimagining of slash sequel to Castlevania 64, which is actually just called Castlevania. Let's crack a lackin'. Can't do anything with a hammer right now.
Careful, Gromit!
Oh, I can kill them. I have to hit the red thing.
Mind yourself, Gromit.
Let's see. It's a porridge machine. I have never had porridge. Is porridge a British thing? Those are Tesla coils. Hey, Simkit.
I've seen one of these before. If we can get it working, it should kickstart the lift. Oh yes, those nuts were just a ticket. I didn't find any raisins. I could murder that old snack.
Emergency lift generator. Maximum of 4 persons at any one time.
I don't think I've ever had porridge. I've had something called that we call a hot cereal, which is actually, actually not what it's called. I don't even remember what brand it is. I think it's Quaker Oats. I used to have that a lot when I was a kid, and, I had it every now and then when I was recovering from my wisdom teeth.
We'll find a use for this, so no mistake.
Genuinely don't know what it's actually called. I think it's a cream of... it's cream of wheat. Pretty sure. When I was a kid, I called it hot cereal. Because I didn't know what cream of wheat was.
I think I'll stay put.
I think I'll stay put, he says. Yeah, I don't have cream of wheat often.
Emergency escape generator. Use with caution. Route also used by coal carts.
Coming, lad. Maybe we should get moving.
Alright, so why can you come all the way over here if you're just gonna tell me to fuck off? Band-aid going off. Could look below me. Well, I have a quick way back up, so I'm gonna go. Cream of wheat is honestly pretty fucking good, and I kind of want some now. I don't think it's the same thing as porridge. I've never had porridge, and you know me, I like food. So I'm willing to try weird foods. Weird British food, on the other hand, is a little much for me. You guys know that one meme of, You guys know that one meme that's like, oh, what is it? It's the two guys in a bus, and one is sad and looking out a window, and there's just dark mountains and grimy shit everywhere. And the other one is looking out the window and he's smiling because all he sees are happy trees and whatnot. One of my favorite versions of that meme is where the sad guy is looking out the window and it says beans British, and the happy guy is looking out the window and it says beans Mexican. I think about that a lot. British people eat like the Germans are still flying overhead. Christ. It's true, though. And then a British commenter says something about school shootings. Yeah, how's that healthcare working out for you, buddy? Is it not underfunded enough? Because they do have better healthcare than the U.S. The problem is, it's severely underfunded, so it might as well not exist.
I'm on my way.
Yeah, like, I know a few people who are British and they fucking hate it there. I know a few people who aren't British and they also hate it there. Alright, there is something over there. I guess I'll... I was supposed to come from the top there. Oh my god, you have got to be shitting me. Damn item I needed was there that whole time. I'm staying here, Gromit, he says as he slowly hikes over. Alright, I guess we're just gonna wait for him. He'll get over here eventually. And to be clear, I have nothing against the British people. But, Britain as a whole, almost every problem in the world's history, the history of the entire world, can be traced back to the British. If you can trace it back to the Americans, you can blame it on the British. Like, nobody was happy that the Queen of England died, except for Native Americans and Mexicans and Aborigines and Chinese and Taiwanese and Irish and Scottish and American and Canadian and Pacific Islander. And basically every other country on the planet was pretty fine with it. Because of just how much the British have done to the rest of the world. By the way, you know the Irish potato famine? The one that's always talked about as being the, a terrible catastrophe of, a single crop failing. Yeah, it was caused by the British. Nobody talks about that. I only just learned of it today, actually. Come on. Do you want me to shoot that? Access to the porridge gun. So I need to look around here for another tool. Oh yeah, Irish people know it, but I'm not Irish. I think. I mean, I'm obviously American, but I think I have Irish blood in me. I'm fine with that. Honestly, Ireland sounds pretty cool. There's a tool over there. Bird is going off on something again. Ew, motherfucking. Alright, I need to find one more fucking tool. You hear Belfast is great? I don't know where that is, unfortunately. Again, why do I have to move up if the P button just says no? What? This game is an enigma. Why is there a loading screen when I unpause? That's the thing that confuses me the most about this game. Are those nuts still there? The birds are confused too. How many times am I gonna do that to myself? I can hear a tool. There is a tool around here. I apparently missed one in the previous area. So I'm gonna backtrack and see if I can find it. This game anymore. forcing your dog into a coal mine considered animal abuse? I would consider that animal abuse. Gotta love the one scam. It's like just buy land in Ireland.
There you go, lad.
And be a lord. I've never heard of that. There's a camera bird stuck here. Well, you wanted a gun.
We need to gum that up somehow, Gromit. Gummed up.
Well, I don't know, because I've never actually heard of that scam before, but...
Fixing this generator might get things moving around.
God, nine. They really make you collect everything. I need two more...
Just what we've been after.
Oh. What are you doing going off at this time? It is 9 o'clock. It is your bedtime.
Top notch, Gromit.
The only reason I know about it is because some old big award show gave it to a bunch of people as part of a gift basket. What in the motherfu- Okay. It was a British award show, wasn't it? I can only imagine it was a British award show. Speaking of British people fucking with other countries. Jowling, Cowling, Rowling, otherwise known as the Turf Wizard Lady, moved to Scotland and voted against its independence. Just in case you needed another reason to ditch the witch bitch. Ooh, I like that phrase. I'm gonna trademark that. Yeah, I mean, that's one of the tamer things she's done. Keep that in mind. And that's terrible. That would be like a white person going to an Indian reservation and then voting against Native American rights. Which I'm sure already happens. In fact, I'm sure it happens all the time. I can guarantee there are people who live to do just that.
Keep going, Gromit. I wonder how we can get up there. Any ideas, old chum?
Wow, I have to use a lot of ammo to do this.
Looks like some kind of landing area. Ooh.
Is that oil?
Crikey, that's some drainage, that is. Holy helicopters, penguins aren't supposed to fly. Oh, we'll never catch him now, unless...
Do we got some bullshit boss fight coming up? Alright, so how do I get up there? Oh, wait, there was the gates that opened. The minecarts on the other side. Oil, mount up, boys. Time to liberate another nation. America, fuck yeah. What are the Welsh up to? Telling British people, or trying to get British people to, desperately trying to get British people to understand that Welsh is an actual language that they speak and is part of the UK. Because I have seen a lot of posts of British Karens insisting that someone needs to learn the language of the nation they live in, despite the fact that the Karen is currently in Wales. I personally don't know much about Wales myself. Other than a fair amount of Doctor Who takes place in Wales for whatever reason. Coin. So that's a coin, yeah? Why is he spinning it like it's a giant bottle cap? I've got a good flag.
Gromit? No, it's just in time. How do you like my twin tub gyrocopter? I'm specially proud of these. Afterburners, lad. Should get us down there, all right? Time for a test flight, though. Just have to give it some welly and hold on. Ready for takeoff, squadron leader.
Why are his ears flapping like wings? Speak fucking English. Wallace just loves to say random shit. On. I have no idea what you're talking about, Simkey. I'm gonna be honest.
With nowhere to run. Go get him, Gromit.
Oh good, the flight controls are inverted.
Those nitro bottles might just help speed us up.
Whoa. Okay. There's a place in Idaho that is known for the worst flag ever. Ah, okay. Oh, now this is sensitive. Oh, I can shoot this whole time? Don't shoot, we're British. Oh my god, this controls like ass. Why is this so sensitive? Why is this so fucking sensitive? This game continues to feel fake. This game is just AI generated. Oh, by the way, did you guys hear what happened to the AI Seinfeld? It got banned from Twitch. Yeah, they had to swap the system they were using to get the AI stuff to work, because the main one had broke, so they used a backup one, and it caused the AI Jerry to go on a rant about how trans people are ruining society. And he got banned for it. Ironically, making him the first comedian to get banned for transphobia. There now. I promise I'll tell the authorities how you cooperated.
Huh? Huh? You should leave the inventing to us professionals. Your trapdoor's stuck.
Why wouldn't you just get off the trapdoor? You had every opportunity, Wallace. You could have just gotten off the damn trapdoor. I struggle to see how this game is 12 hours long. Because I had it in my notes that this game is about 12 hours long. We're already almost halfway through it. Because if I'm not mistaken, there's only 6 levels in the game. Or 6 areas. And we're coming up on the third one.
To our knees in trouble, you know, and no mistake. But where we are, I haven't a clue. And we're not stopping to find out. Look, lad. Look. Oh, that's a bit of a situation, this. How could you get me out of here? Leave this to me, Gromit. The emergency exit's this way.
Loading.
I say, I'm not sure life on the edge agrees with me.
That's when Wallace was calling Gromit. The gorillas. Rescued the gorilla baby over the volcanic pit. Did I not save one of the beavers? I think I missed a beaver. Can't believe Gromit is fucking dead. How can you even see where I am, Wallace? Oh, my ass! Guys. I'm holding a fire extinguisher. game is a mess. Whoops. Told me about the mechanic yet. I just kind of discovered it accidentally. I have a single hit point left. Up the goddamn thing, Gromit. That is an agonizingly slow pace. Counted. Crackers. I want crackers. Do we have any crackers? I'll have to see if we have crackers when I'm done streaming. Yeah, that is definitely fair. By the way, I never got past this part when I was a kid. I definitely do not remember this. I know I got to this area. Well, you're not a kid anymore, so what's your excuse now? Yeah, well, okay, see, the problem is, in some of the spots here, it looks like if I land on the lava, instead of bouncing me back up to the platform like it's supposed to, I just get stuck in an infinite loop of, falling into the lava. Or the lava just instantly kills me. Targeting the enemy I'm trying to avoid, Gromit. Guys, the bucket is empty. Weird-ass looking gorilla. Was I too close that time, but not in the mines? Where are all the boulders coming from? Oh, who knows? Oh boy, Donkey Kong, my favorite. Oh my god, it actually is Donkey Kong.
A use for this, so no mistake.
douchey Kong. Alright, can't grab that. Once again, agonizing them slow.
Good shot, lad. You must be the park gun dog. Pretend you're a rescue dog now, and let that little chap out. This way then, Gromit.
Speak English, dude. I forgot, Wallace just says random bullshit. I don't think I ever did this as a kid. So if the animals can just leave their stations, why couldn't they rescue the babies themselves?
Keep your eyes peeled. Have a good look around. Away you go, Gromit.
All right. I'm actually going to take this as an opportunity to end here. Because this seems like a good spot to end. Gotta love strange British words. It's very British. Too much pressure from their co-workers to keep working. Sure. So, I will end here. This has been illuminating. I did not realize this game was just this nuts. But that is going to be it for stream tonight. I will be back on Wednesday with Castlevania Legacy of Darkness. Let me just get a raid target queued up. Yeah, this game is a lot weirder than I remember it being. Am I going to play this again? Yes, I'm finishing this game. I will be playing this again next week. I am absolutely going to finish this. Because this is one of those games... I wouldn't call this a good game. I wouldn't call it a bad game either. It's just... It's very average. It is painfully average. Wallace and Gromit... Look, Silent Hill 4 tried to do so many things and didn't do any of them particularly well. This game is insane. I want to know what's next. Silent Hill 4, I just wasn't enjoying it. Also, in this, there's no penalty for dying. So I can die as many times as I want. It's going to play the trailer for the game in a moment. So I'm just going to let the trailer play as I pick a raid target. Project Zoom. this was the original trailer for the game that got turned into part of the title screen for some reason.
Go get him, Gromit! Nice going, Gromit.
Please, do not feed the animals.
Feathers look raw.
Yeah, if they were lives, I would probably not be continuing this.
Use a lip slide, jump under the cable, and Gromit will automatically grab onto it. Please mind your footing.
Hey, lad, we're almost on him.
Oh, yeah, sorry about the blind and light flashes, I'd kind of forgotten about them. Somehow.
Hope you didn't damage your undercarriage.
Alright, I'm gonna go to the thanks for watching screen, just because of the white flashes. I still see them because of my monitor. But we are reading Duper. Yeah, well, I mean, do you guys want the bright light flashes, or white flashes in your face while I try to set this up, or... Yeah, if you guys want to look at the trailer, you can just look it up on YouTube. I kind of would like a little less white flashes in my life right now, because if I have the thanks for watching screen up, it's two less screens that are flashing in my face. What should the raid message be? Oh, there's even more white flashes. Good God. What should a raid message be? Oh, wait, I know what it should be. I actually need to look up what this even is. For those of you who have seen Wallace and Gromit's Grand Day Out, you should get this. I think it's the cheese that Wallace thought the moon was made out of. So we will be raiding Duper, the one and only low poly llama. Yeah, Wendsleydale is the cheese that Wallace thinks the moon is made out of, because, you know, on the moon is made of cheese. Yeah, see you guys. I will see you all on Wednesday. You guys have a good evening. And I will see you then. Good night. Close enough, pal. I don't care.
Wallace and Gromit in Project Zoo.